So this was a lot worse than I expected.
It wasn't really.
The fact that your doctor's meeting you at his office on a day he's closed. Not to mention the fact the first time he talked to you was on a Sunday.
Yeah, he started all this on a Sunday.
So, the surgery went very well, okay? The only concerns and issues that I have are two things. One is the bicep tendon was really shredded. When I mean shredded, I'm gonna go over two things. From where it was attached, it was torn in multiple areas, and then the tendon itself going up was shredded. That makes sense? So when I don't want to say shredded, I mean it was torn in sort of kind of what we call the longitudinal fashion, meaning from north to south.
So torn this way,
torn this way,
up that way,
and torn this way. Yeah. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So it's almost kind of like when you look at the tendon almost looks like it's like a tube. Mm-hmm. So imagine that, a tube. So the muscle, you had a tube. And what happened was you had torn it from where it attaches, and then you tore it going up the tendon. And so you have the muscle, and it looks like strings of spaghetti. Does that make sense?
Oh, that video you showed Rebecca.
Yeah.
That's horrible.
Yeah. So we have to do two things. One is we had to, this is important for you, because that's what you understand. We had to reattach it, all right? But then we also had to tularize it. What does that mean? So it's supposed to be a tube, mm-hmm. but it was flat, all right? So I had to repair that back so that those fibers that were torn in the north and south can heal. That makes sense?
But they can heal.
They can heal. They can if you behave. Now, this is important.
Yeah.
It's important. Second thing is, let's talk about that. So we got a good repair back. And I think what happened, it shows me that you probably injured this maybe more than once. Does that make sense? I think you probably, your last go probably was the actual, but I think you, in the past, you had injured it more than once. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Along the tendon sheath.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? Because it also had scarred down to some other tissues, all right? So the body will say, well, I am not really attached to where I'm supposed to be attached. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create the scar tissue along the tendon. And what that was doing is that was then scarring down to the other muscles associated with it. Cause that's what it wants to do. It wants to find a home.
Right.
Got it? Mm-hmm. So we had to pull that off, just clean that all up, do what we need to do. The second thing we had to do was, which I was concerned about, was we did remove a lot of the bone spurs. So obviously you had that big, huge bone spur in the front. Then you had some bone spurs around the radial head, which is what prevented you from getting supination, right? And so it took me a long, that's what most of my time doing was really, the first part was removing all the bone spurs, removing the bone spurs from the front, and then from the radial head, and then trying to get over to the inside of the elbow without disrupting all the nerves and vascular structures and the caps.
Mm-hmm.
We were able to get a significant amount off. I'm not sure if I sent you the x-rays. So have you seen them yet or no?
The new x-rays? Yeah.
And you saw that?
Elbow looked good.
The thing with this is you see that your elbow's in a joint.
Mm-hmm.
You see you still got some arthritis, but it's not too bad. But you can see now, as far as it's concerned, I was able to get you full supination. You saw in that video.
You saw that,
which is good, right? I was able to get you about here flexion.
With rehab, I might even get more range of motion.
I think that's the plan.
Oh, awesome.
That's the plan. That's what I hope. But at the end of the day, you know, let's not lose the motion that you have.
Absolutely not.
And then get that over time.
So just my arm, my elbow is totally trashed, basically.
Absolutely.
But do you think that the tendon tears could have been possibly because of all the bone?
I do. I think there's a combination of both. Think of almost like a coral reef.
Okay.
That makes sense?
Yeah.
It's kind of like you have a coral reef inside your elbow, right? And all your tendons are just going against that coral reef.
Just scraping.
Just scraping it. And I think that's probably what contributed to a lot of the tears in the different
north
and south. Does that make sense? And go from there.
Yes, sir.
All right, so the other issue is because you have bone spurs all over, my biggest issue is, you know, not only you deal with stretching of the tissue, you also deal with damaging of the nerves. So a lot of the nerves were just, that's why you had sensation issues and things like that. A lot of the nerves got damaged as well. So I protected them as much as I could, dissected around them, tried not to stretch them as much as we could, removed a lot of the bone spurs, stuff we could, tried to free up a lot of stuff. So we'll see how you do. So you may have some numbness and tingling in breast areas for a little while, but it should get better. That's what I'm hoping. All right? All right? How you feel? You
can, I mean, so, it's all, can I, am I allowed to do that?
I'm glad that you can do that, brother.
Okay, because that's what I need to know. Not need to know, but curious about. What can I do that hurts this?
Like, okay.
Is moving this bad?
I think moving that's fine. Okay. For now. I think so. Because you move your thumb, good. You move your, you can extend your fingers, that's awesome. Because you can bring your wrist up.
You can fire your wrist backwards?
Yeah, you can fire your wrist. Yeah, that's perfect. That's what I need to know. Okay. The fact that you can do that's fine.
Good.
Okay? With you, we just got to let this thing heal, brother. Okay? I mean, so this was a lot worse than I expected.
Was it really?
Absolutely. Because I didn't expect the tendon to be torn in multiple directions. I thought it would be like, you know, I didn't think you were going to give me the cottage, I mean, not the, the Swiss cheese tendon.
That video that you said is ridiculous.
Oh,
that doesn't even look, I don't know what the hell that looks like.
Yeah, well, I don't either. I was like, I think it's a tendon. It looks like a tendon. It's supposed to be a tendon, but it looks like some dogs chewed on it. it looked like a chew toy.
It did.
All right. Yeah, like,
were you able to reattach it in the ways that you wanted to?
Yeah, I did. Okay. I did. The only thing I didn't put a screw in because the tendon was so big and so it was so big. Your tendon is so big, and I wanted to keep a lot of the tendon in there because it was a lot of it was scar tissue. It didn't allow us to do that, but we backed it up. I backed it up. Multiple ways.
So that's the button holding the tendon down, so we know it's up against the bone, so we know that's okay. Where it needs to be.
That's where it is.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, and then look at your elbow. Looks normal now.
It looks normal.
So, I mean, we gotta say it's about as normal as we're gonna get it,
right?
But it hasn't looked that good in 13 years.
Okay. So, you know, it was kind of hinging on something, and it created its own joint.
Okay.
So one of the things that is gonna make sense for you. This is why it's important to stabilize it, keep it in a splint for 2 weeks, then we take it out, and then we get our range of motion.
Okay.
Well, we'll stay in for 2 weeks.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
How's that feel?
It's just tingling. I mean, it's you know, it's just asleep still.
But yeah, I feel that?
Yeah, I feel everything.
Okay.
It's like you're just scratching a little bit.
Move that again. But you can feel that. You can feel that here.
Mm-hmm.
Feel that here. Mm-hmm. Feel that here. You can feel that there.
It just, you know, it feels asleep. But okay. Yeah, it's tingly.
Right.
Yeah, I feel it. But yeah, I mean, there's a certain sensation and everything.
What was it like before you had this? You couldn't really feel your fourth and fifth fingers.
These two fingers were just kind of always numb. Just,
all right.
You know.
So it's the same numbing you feel that it was before surgery, or is it a little different?
I can't be sure. It's all tingly. You
it's
know?
All tingly. Okay.
Yeah. But I mean, they're all tingly. So it's not just these.
Okay.
So, everything feels the same to me right now,
okay.
As far as the hand goes, but it's probably a different feeling than. So what had started happening is after I got the last round of stem cells, I didn't know if it was healing the tendon or not the tendon, but the nerve, because I was starting to get weird sensations occasionally.
You was like little twitches, yeah, things, like stuff I
would
like, that.
Like do something with my hand this way, and then it would shoot. I was like, oh wow. You know, because if I do some of these two fingers, it would just send a sensation down my arm. I'm like, oh, that's weird. But I hadn't really felt that in a long time. So I didn't know that was a good thing or a bad thing. But like I said, I thought that the stem cells had healed it back.
Yeah. What, your tendon?
Well, yeah. Because I partially tore it.
Yeah.
Well, not partially. It was like almost a complete tear October 20th. And then I came home, got the MRI, and I guess that was on the first step scan. I guess y'all didn't see those because you didn't see the disc.
Right,
but.
Right.
Then I got stem cells, and then 4 weeks later, I got stem cells and exons and all that stuff, and it showed complete reattachment. It's
right.
Just, I didn't know what the tensile strength was, you know?
I agree with you. And that's not a bad thing, that's just how some things work.
And reading this off.
You right?
Mm-hmm.
Looks good, though.
Looks really good. and it hurts.
It just means stretch it out.
I know,
it hurts.
I know.
It's okay. You're the doc. Do whatever you want to do. I trust you.
That's what they said.
So the prognosis, with all the cleaning up of the tendon that you did and the reattaching,
right.
If he allows it to heal like it's supposed to heal, he's definitely starting with something that's in better condition than what he was working with. Okay.
Oh, absolutely. He has gained back a good 10, 15 years of his elbow life.
Okay.
Right? Because he's been working with this thing and it's been torn for a while. In addition to that, he's had limited motion, and he's been scraping up against the bone here and there. So the bone is scraping up against the tendon. Is that okay?
I think
so. Yeah. Give you a little bit more.
Yeah.
All right, champ. How's that?
No, I like it. You
moving everything? That's the most important thing.
So I'm allowed to do all of this.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. I just don't want none of this. Okay.
Yeah. So I could do this even while I have this on. I could sit here. And
yeah.
Do that.
Oh, yeah. Because you're gonna go crazy if you don't.
But it's
gotta do something.
Do something.
But I had like a little squeeze ball.
Perfect.
I will be doing movements with my left arm just to keep myself going, but it won't
care. I don't care what's left.
Okay.
Neither does anybody else.
But we just got to be careful on that. And then bring you back, take you out of that, make sure everything's okay. Then we're going to put you in a hinge brace, okay? Mm-hmm. You'll switch from a hinge brace.
Okay.
And probably what I'll do is I'll probably order an extra large since I'm still looking, thinking ahead. Even though they only come in one size, I'm just gonna say, call my guy and say, listen, I need a. This guy's arm is massive.
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 Press can't train for helpless, too optimistic about recovery and rehab.
So, well, listen, brother, I'm gonna say something to you. You're a champion for a reason. And the reason why you're feeling what you're feeling, because it's just normal. That's normal. How you feel is very normal. All great athletes go through this, trust me. You know what I mean? So what you're feeling is not abnormal. Also, you're on pain medicine, you just got anesthesia. It's still pleasant, you're still in your system. So you go through a feeling of like you're feeling good, then you're down. So the most important thing for you to do is get some rest. Make sure you take care of your mental capacity. That's the most important thing. And at the end of the day, you know, you can't rush God's work, right? You gotta just heal. Healing is part of being a good athlete, right?
Yes, sir.
So you can do what you can do, but at this point now, this is where the mental toughness comes in. What got you to where you are, one of the things that you always said to me is that you were gifted because you worked hard. You outworked everybody. And you have to understand that all the hard work you paid off that's got you where you are is gonna come back. So just relax. It's only day one. How you're feeling is very normal. We got a long road ahead of us. You know what I mean? This is the time you want to meditate. You want to concentrate. You want to prepare your mind mentally to get ready for the comeback. Because that's what this is, the comeback.
Yes, sir.